Shout out to Real Talk Media in the building. Respectable blog spot, man. Y'all need to tap into it. If y'all ain't following Real Talk Media, go follow the homie, man. That nigga uncut. He facts over feelings by nature. He don't give a fuck. He gonna call it how you see it. Ain't giving a fuck about these industry niggas' feelings. Salute.
What's going on, YouTube? This your boy Real Talk. Now tuned into Real Talk Media. Got something different to talk about today, boy. Okay, first off, I apologize for the audio. Second off, man, shout out to the Real Talk Mafia, because whether y'all agree with me or disagree with me, y'all still been rocking with me. So if it wasn't for y'all, this channel wouldn't be shit. With that being said, though, yo, y'all know I posted a video the other day where I said Casanova pulled up on Soulja Boy and checked the shit out of him and the security. And some of y'all disagree. Y'all feel like security and Soulja Boy stood their ground. And you know what? That's what this channel here for. That's what the comment section here for. I'm not one of them niggas that say, you gotta agree with me or get the fuck off my channel. With that being said, Joe, Spider Loke had to react to that. Before I play that clip, I must say that Casanova and Soulja Boy did go online and somewhat clarify the situation. Whether y'all took that clarification or not, that's on y'all. I still stand by what I said. But let's see what Spider Loke got to say about this.
Is the nigga Casanova trying to play Captain Save a Hole and bully Soulja Boy at the same time, my nigga? Yeah, you caught the boy in whatever little situation you caught him. It looked like you marked out the situation, marked out his bodyguard and all that. That was cool, but what was your real issue? Captain Save a Whole Ass Nigga, my nigga. You know how vulgar hip-hop is, especially gangster rap is, and the referencing the females. So, I mean, like, I don't get what that whole little stunt was about, my nigga. That shit was corny, cuz. I wish that nigga Soulja Boy would have nutted up like he been nutting up on all these videos and shit, cuz. You was supposed to nut up, little homie, on my mama. This nigga done told the whole world he could carry a pound of cargo in his asshole. And now he checking you about anything is out of line. And I'm also so amazed to see all these supposedly gangbangers have all these intense conversations, and all of a sudden no gang references come out their mouth. I could have swore I just seen this nigga Soulja Boy, for one, picking his homie up, having all the fun in the world. He said Paru about 5 times, and each Paru seemed out of place. But now you in this tense situation when it's time to, like, even when you made your rants to the industry, then no blood, no Paru come out your mouth. This nigga Young Buck is having all these meltdowns when all your emotions is involved, and you talking crazy, you talking aggressive, and you forget to say 60s Crip, neighborhood, cuz, or any of that. I don't even think I heard the nigga Casanova say blood and Pyro, but it's Bracken blood on the record, though. When you really in activity pushing your line, I ain't hear none of them references. Y'all got to remember, the camera always on, so y'all going to pretend to be a part of this. You got to always pretend, my nigga. Not when you get serious, all of a sudden you forget what you was pretending to be, my nigga. Because one like myself take all those type of references out of this conversation intentionally when it's appropriate. But when you upset and lost it, that's basically when you really say just about anything and everything that you really feeling. So if it's really on Pyro, that's when it's going to come out. If it's really on Bloods, that's when it's going to come out. If it's really on Crip, that's when it's going to come out. If it's really on 60s or Neighborhood, that's when you're going to say it. You talking about a nigga robbing you for money. I imagine millions. You telling the whole world. You scared to say his name, and you still don't throw none of that shit in there, cuz. That is the evidence of the lack of authenticity of what these niggas is really engaged themselves in, bro. It ain't me seeing it, me saying it. It's y'all seeing it and hearing it. It's them doing it, them showing it. You feel me? When you really on your tip, cuz, that's when niggas get dissed and all that. You see what happened? I don't give a fuck. Soon as Daz got really feeling some way, he got the gangbang talking, cuz. And he went a little too far, but for the public platform such as he was in, especially if he felt the need to issue an apology. But you know what I'm saying, when niggas really be on, that's when it be on. That's, I don't get it, cuz. That shit corny to me, my nigga. But Soulja Boy, when you bring that kind of energy, my nigga, that's what you asking for. You talking about all rappers and all that, you don't give a fuck and all that. Damn, homie, you can't get on caught on camera turning it down like that, my nigga. Now, you bet not get caught with that same security nigga on camera no more. That nigga need to be booted up out this motherfucker, cuz. Boo boo. He should have just ended his whole career. Should nobody hire cuz ever again. Oh, this just me, homie. I'm for you, cuz. More cuz out. Oh, that shit was funny, cuz. The internet wins again.
Hey, Whether y'all like him or not, the nigga made a lot of valid points, and he echoed a lot of the same sentiments that I said in my blog. So with that being said, he also told me to make sure y'all hit him up on Instagram at his new page, SpiderLokeMostEastie7. His other page is gone, so hit him up at SpiderLokeMostEastie7. With that being said, drop a comment down below and let me know what y'all think about this. I'm on Twitter at RealTalkBlogs. I'm on Instagram at RealTalkBlogger. Yo, this shit crazy. I'm out. But ain't saying shit when they rhyme. But if the beat's something they can dance to, then they think it's something they like.